Bob Dylan was more than iconic Sunday night in the woodlands outside of Houston. He rocked and he grooved. Yeah, Bob Dylan is an icon, and one that I hadn't seen since 2003 at the Heineken Hall in Amsterdam. And the most exciting thing about that show was watching one of our party, Carol in Wonderland, go backstage to meet with Bob in intermission time. Even so, I hadn't planned to go, but the girl got some free tickets at the radio station. So I saddled up the Blue Scion and drifted north to the woodlands on a hot, humid Texas summer night. I'd heard that Bob had taken to saying he was from Texas in some European interviews. It seemed like more amusing Bobness with the press. But last night I found out that his reasons for making that statement went deeper than they initially appeared to go. The band's groove was deep. Musically, the varied histories and hometowns of these musicians didn't matter at all. On this tour, the Bob Dylan Show featured a great Texas roadhouse band. Every musician on stage was playing rhythm most of the time. The band's groove was deep, I tell you. No solos except for a few from Bob himself. Bob's suit was black, and his hat was white. The rest of the band wore all black with white sports coats that probably carried the sweat of a half dozen previous performances. Rearranging old classics into mostly Texas shuffles on this tour, the band played those as if they had all grown up on the Texas Gulf Coast. It felt good. Watching those fellas in their matching jackets and hats, I felt pretty old school. I felt like I was 14 years old in 1966 again, sneaking out of the house and taking the old dart to some faraway East Texas dance to see some space-age Ernest Tubb and the Texas Troubadours. That old dance hall was made out of wood and nails, but this place was all steel and concrete. 50-foot-tall black velvet curtain with individually cool light patterns projected to it for each song. A far cry from the stage which hosted Ernest, B, Muddy, Buddy, and Hank. The old hippies and grandkids around me tonight were a far cry from my old teenage musician buddies, or that 16-year-old Mexican girl with the braces that took me outside during Ernest Tubb's intermission and taught me more about kissing and the danger of kissing with braces than I had ever expected to learn. Ouch, that hurt. Bob's still in Texas for a spell. He's at Round Rock tonight, playing in the stadium where the Astros AAA Farm Club, the Express, play their games. Bob Dylan's an icon for his poetry, his vision, and his social influence. But tonight, he'll be playing a bunch of Texas shuffles. Ain't that cool?